Hello everyone, this is Jyoti from woocommerce.com, and today in this video I'm going to tell you how to design this beautiful e-commerce website by using one of the most popular WordPress theme named as Flatsome. As you can see, that Flatsome theme is the number one e-commerce theme. It's best selling e-commerce theme at present. So as you can see, this is the top right menu and that is the top left menu. After that, this is my logo and this is the main menu bar. After that, there is a slider. Okay. And you can see some zoom in and zoom out effect. Okay. See, this photo have some zoom in and zoom out effect. It's looking very beautiful. There is some text with the button. And this is some feature of the website, like free shipping, all product added every day, or every day you can add the new products like that, and 24/7 the customer care is there. Okay, after that the feature products, it's a slider of course, and this is the categories, and all the product categories will be displayed here. And when you hover that in this, as you can see, this man dresses, in man dresses there will be the 10 products. Like that lingerie category have the 10 products. So when you hover on the particular category, all the product count of the following category will be displayed there. And if you want to launch some product after certain duration, or if you want to launch some sale after certain duration, so you can set a timer like that. Okay. It's really look very beautiful. And this is the on sale product slider. And after that is the best selling product slider. And that is the blog. Okay. And after that, the footer gets started here. And here you can see all the latest product, best selling products, feature products, and on sale products. And that is the footer 2 area. Here you can see some about us with some social media icons and all the recent posts and all the product tags. And here is the address. And in the footer tagline, you can see the copyright text and the payment gateway icons. Okay, after that come back to the about us page. In the about us page you can see some beautiful banner with the about us text and some subheading also with a button, and after that there is some text with our team. Similarly the footer is also here. After that come back to the shop page. Okay, this is the shop page. Here you can see all the products. Okay, and that is in the right hand side. Here you can see some sidebar is there. Here is the filter by price. Okay, we can apply the filter, and all the product categories is displaying here. When you click in the some categories, the product related to that category will be get displayed like that. Here I click the man dresses, so all the product related to man dress is displaying here. Okay, and after that there is the pagination. Okay, I mean if you click in this two, it will go in the next page. And again the footer, after that there you can see the product categories. Okay, when you hover on that, the sub menu will open. Here you can see all the categories. After that, this is the blog page. Blog page look like that. Okay, if you want to read the post in details, you have to click in this continue reading. So like that the full post will be displayed here. And here if you want to comment something, you can do it. After that there is the contact us page. In the contact us page you can see the Google map in the top of the page. After that there is the accordions. Okay, when you click on that, the bottom text will be displayed like that. This is the accordion title and this is the accordion body. Okay, and this is the contact form, and again that is the footer. Now let's come back to the shop page. When you click on a single product, the single product page will look like that. Here is the images, and when you click on that, that image will be get pop up, and this is the related images. Okay, that is called the short description, that is the product name, and that is the product rate. After that it's asking for the quantity. You can increase or decrease, and that is the add to cart button. And here is the add to wish list. Okay, and this is the product description, and if there is some review, it will be displayed here. Else you can post your own review. And this is the deleted products. After that, if you click in this login, here you can see if you already have an account, then you just by simply fill this username and password, and after that hitting the login. You doesn't have any account, in this case you have to register. For that you have to give your mail ID, first name, last name, gender, phone number, and this is optional where you can know about the website from Google, Facebook or so and so options. Okay, after that you have to click in the register. Suppose I am a new user, so I am giving my mail ID here. After that I am giving my name as Deb and giving the phone number, and I get to know about the website from Facebook, and after that clicking the register. After that you will get a mail that will contain the password. Okay, after that you can buy the products like that. Click in the add to cart. Now this pop-up will appear. After that you have to click in this checkout or view cart. Let's click in the checkout. Now it asking all the details, your company name, it's optional of course, and after that your country. I'm from India. Okay, so I'm clicking this India. After that your original address you have to give, town, and after the state and country. So I'm typing Telangana, and zip code, and your phone number already you given. Okay, after that here you have to choose the payment option, the direct bank transfer, PayPal, cash on delivery. So many option is there. I am choosing that cash on delivery. After that clicking this place order. So now it's showing the order details with the order number and everything. From here also you can see your order like that, from my account and order. Here also you can see, and you can see this order in the processing. Okay, so now let's log in as a admin. Okay, now I am giving my admin ID and password and clicking the login. Come back to my WordPress dashboard. From there you have to come in WooCommerce and orders. As you can see, this is my order details with the order number. Just click in the order. You can see the status is in processing. Okay, so you can see the order details, when the order get and how the payment of the method and everything, you can see it. After that here you can see the order in action, order action. Okay, so there is so many options like email, invoice, resend the new order notification, something like that you can do it. And suppose you already processed the order, so you can click in this complete also. Suppose you already seen that you get the order and you want to put this order in hold for some time, then you can keep this option as on hold. Okay, that is so many option. Suppose the product is not available, so you can make the cancel like that. If you want to refund, then you can do like that. The order is failed, so you can make it failed. Suppose I already complete the order, so click in the complete and in up, click in the update. Now your customer also see that order get delivered and the order is completed like that. So let's start to design the website. To design this website, first of all you have to go to wordpress.org. from there you have to click in this get WordPress. After that this page will open. After that just click in this download WordPress. Whatever the version, you have to download it. You will get a zip file like that, that will contain this WordPress file. I need this WordPress file. Okay, after that this Google XAMPP, that is the local server, because I am making this website or I am making this tutorial as a designing purpose, as a practice purpose. So here I doesn't use any real domain name or a hosting account. Okay, so it's a local server. So after that, opening this, you have to click in this download option. If you use the Windows, then download the latest version, this 7.4.3, this one. I am also using this. If you use the Linux, then you can download this, and if you are a Mac user, then go for these options. Okay, after download you have to install that XAMPP. Okay, after that you have to open that XAMPP control panel. It will look like that. Just open it. After that you have to start the Apache and MySQL. They both will become green. Just minimize it. After that, take a new tab in your browser, type localhost. After that, come to the PHP MyAdmin. You have to create a new database, so just click in this new option, and after that you have to enter the database name. Here I am giving something Flatsome B2, and this is case sensitive, so remember. After that, click in this create. So database gets created now. Now what I have to do? You have to open my computer. From there, just browse in the C drive. There will be a folder called XAMPP. And in between, there will be a folder called htdocs. Now that WordPress file, what you already downloaded, just drag and drop it here. I have to rename this as same Flatsome B2. Okay, now open it. Here there will be folder named WP content. You have to open it. In between there will be theme file. Open it. By default there is total 4 theme, but you does not need that. So you can keep this if you want, else you can delete of them also. Now I'll give this file link in my video description. That will contain theme file, all the plugin and all the images. So open the theme file. I need the Flatsome theme, so just copy it here. After that, open the plugins, and in the video description folder also you have to open the plugins. All the plugins, just copy it here. Okay, now open a new tab. Type localhost and the folder name in B2. Now you have to install the WordPress or set up the WordPress. Click in this continue. I'm choosing English as my language. Let's go. And database name should be same as it is. Okay. Username should root, password no need, database host will be localhost, and table prefix I am keeping as WP only. Click in the submit, run the installation, give the site title, I am giving the same site title. Username and password I am keeping as admin. I recommend you give a strong password. Okay, this is for demo website, so I am keeping as admin only. Give your real mail ID. Okay. And this is a demo website. I does not want to index this as Google, so just tick this, and after that click in this install WordPress. After that click in this login, give the username and password, and after that again click in this login. After that come to appearance and themes, activate the Flatsome theme. Click in the let's go, and this is the key, and that is activated theme. Okay, so by default this key will come. If it not come, just pause the video and copy the key and enter in your website. After that click in the continue. I does not need any child theme, so keep these steps. I have to download and activate this plugin, so click in the continue. it will take some time. After that, this page will open. I does not need any demo content, so skip this. Here it asking to upload your logo. I'll do it later, so skip this step. Agree and continue. Okay, so setup is ready. Now it asking to set up the WooCommerce. So click in this. So you have to select your country. I'm from India. Choose the India address. Enter the city name now. State will be Telangana. Zip code. And it's the currency, so I have to type the INR. And I want to sell the physical product, so choose the physical. And after that, click in the let's go. Continue. It's asking your PayPal ID. And this is the offline payment method also is there. If you want to activate them, you can do it. Click in the continue. After that, it's asking for the shipping rate. If you can keep the free shipping, else you can apply some rate also. And the measurement unit will be in kilogram and centimeter. Yeah, click in the continue. As I don't need this, so just skip that. This also skip. Visit dashboard. After that, click in this plugins. Click in this inactive. And only activate this one, this NSS O registration forms, activate this one. Okay, now let's come back to the pages. Before creating any pages, let's upload all the images. So click in this media. Now open the folder which link I already give you in the video description. From there open the images and select all the images, all the images, and just and drag and drop here. It will take so many time, I know it, so I'll come back. All the images get uploaded. Okay, so all the images get uploaded now. It will take almost for me 5 minutes. Okay, so don't worry if it take time. So let's come back to the pages. I have to create some pages, so click in this add new, give the name as home, publish it again, click in this add new, about us, about us, publish it, blog, publish. You can click the add new and the add the last page as contact us and publish it. Now click in the pages, click in the home page, click in this edit with UX builder, delete this one, double click content block, delete that, click in the add element. Before that, just click in this, come to the template and select this one, page full with transparent header, light text. After that, go back, click in the add element, search for the slider, this one. Now click in this plus icon, from there click in the banner, choose this one, the left, and after that make the height as 100% because I want the full page and full height. Okay, now select the background image, click in this, come to the media library, choose this image and use this image. After that, in hover, make it a zoom logo. Okay, and here also make it a zoom. Okay, so zooming effect will enable. After the click in this text box, remove everything. Write the Flatsome tutorial as heading 1. Okay, make it as heading 1. After that, come back to the next line. and wrote the best WooCommerce theme ever and make it as heading 3. I want this should be come in a single line, so make it like that. Drag and hold like that. If you want to change this text, like something, no more. Okay, so after that, click in the apply. Similarly, add another banner. So click in this plus icon and take this banner and the left one. Again, cut this cross icon. After that, you have to select the media. I'm taking this one, use this image, and after that make it as 100%. Now again change the effect as zoom long and hover alt will be zoom. Okay, again click in this text box, remove everything, new fashion every day, it will be the heading 1 and the subheading will be new latest dress collection every day and make it as H3. Okay, again just drag it little bit so it will come in a single line like that. If you does not need this button, just you can delete it like that. Okay, so it's done here. After that click in the update. So now I have to design this icon box. For that, come back here, click in this add element, search for the session, take any one. I'm taking this default one, you can take this default dark also if you want. Click in the apply. After that, change the background as deep black. Okay, now again click in this add element and take this row. In a single row there will be 3 column, by default is 3 column only, so click in the apply. I want some top padding, make it as 20, and bottom padding also, let's taking as 10 pixel. Click in the apply, click in the add element, search for the icon box. This one is the icon box. Now I need this icon, so click in the select media and this is the icon. Use this image. The position of the image should be in left. After that click here. I need this text, so just copy it. Just copy this text and paste it here. Similarly here, click in this add element, again search for the icon box, this one, select the icon. I need this icon, use this image, and the position should be in the left, and this text I need, so copy it, click in the text block and paste it. Okay, icon not appear, what happened? Okay, it's perfect now. Now this one, so I can click here, search for the icon box, select media, there will be SVG file, this one, use this image, make the position as left. And I need to change the text also. So remove everything and copy the text. Okay, it's perfect now. Let's apply and update it. So now I have to make this feature product heading and after that this feature product the sliders. But before that, I have to make some product post, because till now I doesn't have any product, so I have to create the product, then only I can make this. Okay, so for that you have to come back to the dashboard. After that, click in this product and categories. Click in the edit option. Make it as woman's dress. Come down. Here I have to upload the category picture. You can choose any picture. I am choosing this picture as category picture. Okay. After that, click in the update. Again, click in the category. Next category will be shoes. Again, I have to upload the image. I am choosing this image as shoes category image. Again, click in the add to new category. Add new category. Okay. Next will be lingerie. Again, I have to add the image. I am choosing this image as lingerie category image. Again, add new category. Next category will be man's dress. For that also, I am choosing this image as man's category or man's dress. Okay. Again, click in the add new category. After that, click in the all products. To create the product, click in this create product. Now here I have to give the product name first of all. After that, you have to choose the category. After that, you can add some tag like red, lingering, like that. After that, you have to give the product description. You can add any text. Okay, give the date of the product, like I am taking as 900, and if the product is on sale, then you can mention the sale price, something like 800, but remember the regular price should be larger than the sale price. Okay, and after that you have to select the product image. I am selecting this image as a product image and add to gallery. Now press Ctrl or Command key and select multiple related image like that, and after that click in this add to gallery like that. Again, this is the product short description. Copy some text, okay, and just paste it here. Okay, like that. You can make them as a list item also, and after that publish. This is how to create a simple product. I'm going to tell you how to create the variable products. So click in the add new to post the next product. After that, give the product name. After that, the product description. And this is actually I take as a table format. Okay, if you want, I'll give the code in the video description how to create the table. Okay, that is the folder given in the video description. From there, open this text file. That is the whole the code for the product description. After that, come back to the attribute and select that as a variable product. Okay, come back to the attribute, add, make sure you checked all the box, okay, and make it a size, and will be small, and give the symbol for separation, okay, and large. This is the two attribute I am adding. And after that, save attribute. If you want to add another attribute, then again click in the add, check all the boxes. Color I am giving as white, and the separator after that black, and again save the attribute. This variable products means like you have several sizes of the product and in different colors, but you want to give the different rate for the different sizes and different color. For that you have to use that variable product. Okay, and after that click in the variations. here click this create variation from all attributes, and after that click in the go, and here OK. Click in the OK. So as you can see, total 4 variation get added. So click any one of them. You can upload the image here. Let's select this one, set variation image. Okay, and the regular price I'm giving as 1800 in stock, and you can change this parameter as well. Here it's a dummy project, so I'm not going to change anything. Again click in this black, upload the image, and taking this image, set variation image, its price I'm keeping as 1600. Again L white, for that again I'm taking this one, and the rate I'm giving as 2000, and for this one I'm taking this image, set variation, and rate I'm keeping as something 1700, something like that, and after that click in the save changes. After that, that is the product short description. Okay, I'm giving this dummy text. Now for the common product, you have to upload a product image. Make sure any of the variation image you can add here. I'm taking this one, set the product image, and in the product gallery similarly add some similar images, like I'm selecting all the images and clicking the add to gallery. After that choose the category as lingerie, and if you want to add some tag you can add it. After that click in the publish. The variable products look like that, means by default no date will be displayed. You have to choose the size and you have to choose the color, then only you can see the date is displaying. If you choose different size, then you can see the rate gets changed automatically like that. Similarly, I'm adding so many products in different categories because it will take lot of time. So after adding all the images, I will come back. So as you can see, I already created almost 42 products in different categories. Now, one thing I want to tell you, you can see this star icon. It's called the featured. Normally this product are normal product, but when you click on this, this product will be become a feature product. Just wait, as you can see, after clicking this, this product become feature product. Similarly, I'm taking another some product as a feature product like that. Okay, I create so many feature products. You can return back to the page and home page, edit with UX builder. It's loading. So now I have to design this heading. So come back here, click in this in between the session, add to session, this one, search for title, take this one, the title is as feature product. Okay, and make it as, keep it as H3 only, and it will be, should be center alignment. Okay, the style should be centered. Okay, and yeah, click in the apply. After that again click in the add to session. Now search for the product, this one, products. Click in the feature products, okay, because I want feature products. Click in the apply. Okay, it's come here. If you want to change the style, like overlay, so many effect is there, you can make it. Like if you keep the overlay, you can see this text start appearing on the images, but I doesn't like that, so I'm keeping as default. Okay, it's look beautiful for me. After that click in the apply. Now I have to design this browse, this heading, and this categories. Okay, so again come here, search for the title and keep it at center alignment. and apply. Click here. Now search for product categories. This one, product categories. Okay, it's coming like that. I like this overlay style. Okay, it's look more beautiful. Okay, it's looking very good. And when you hover on that, the count of the product related to that category is displaying here. Okay, after that, click in the apply and update it. Now, one thing you can observe, this image size a little bigger compared to that. So for that, I have to come back to the dashboard, the Flatsome, here theme option. From here, come to WooCommerce, product images, and here just click in this uncropped. Now you can see these images are coming in the full width and full height. Okay, after that, publish it. Okay. Now let's update it again and refresh the page. Now you can see the image is coming in the full height. Okay. So now I have to design this timer with this text. Come back here. You can click in the add element, session, click in the default and apply. After that, open it. I have to choose the image. I'm choosing this image as a background image. So after that, select this image, click in this use this image. After that, increase the parallax level as 8. Okay. After that, click in the add element. Select the row and single row, single column, this one column, apply. After that, click in the add element. Take the text layer, text. After that, select this heading uppercase and apply. I need this text. Okay, open the text editor. Okay, and the color of the text I need as white color. Click in the custom and take the white color. Sorry, I forgot to select the text. Okay, perfect. And I need the center alignment, so select all and make the center aligned. After that, click in the OK and click in this add to column. Search for countdown, this one. You have to specify when you want to launch the product. 2020, make it as 8. Okay, and yeah, like that, the countdown already started. Click on the apply. Now I want some padding because the image is not showing properly. Okay, so come back here in the row, give some top padding, something 60 pixel, and down padding also I'm giving something like 30 pixel. Click in the apply. Okay, it's looking more good now. After that, I have to design this on sell products. So again, click in the add element, session, and after that, default, click on the apply. And here I have to make the back color of the background as dark black. Okay, click in this, search for title. Okay, and give the title here, and should be center aligned. Color will be white. Apply. and after that again clicking this, search for the product, take this products, and I have to take the on sale product. Here you can see on sale, select this and click the apply. Okay, it's perfect. If you want to add some gap here, you can give it, search for the gap, and gap should be like some 60 pixel and apply. Okay, it's perfect. One thing you can observe, this text are not looking beautiful. This text color is not in white color as you can see in this. So for that, what you have to do, just come back to the theme option, come to the layout. Here you can see the content color, dark background and white text, this one. Click in the publish. Now if you refresh the page, it's coming perfect. So after that, I have to make this best selling products. So again click in this, search for title, this one, the title should be best selling products, and make it at center, apply. Again click in this, search for the products, click in this best selling, okay, and click on the apply. Okay, it's perfect. Now with the latest news, and that is the blog. Okay, so till I doesn't create any blog, so for that you have to come back to the dashboard, click in the post and add new. Okay, here I have to give the title of the post, after that body of the post, I mean on the article you have to give it. Come back to the document, here you can see the feature image, set feature image, click in this. I'm taking this image, set feature image, and after that publish. Again click in this add new, give the title, after that body, document, set the feature image. I'm selecting this image as a feature image, set feature image, and after that click in the publish. Again click in the add new, give the title, give the body, and after that again feature image. I'm taking this one, set as feature image, and publish. So as you can see, I already created multiple posts, so you can come back here, click in this, you can search for title, and the title should be the latest news. So copy it, okay, and make it at center alignment, apply, and again search for the blog post, keep it normal only and apply. Okay, everything looks perfect. You can see read more to bottom is there, read more. So for that, what do you do, scroll it down, here the read more, you have to type that read more. Okay, it's perfect. The color I'll change it later, don't worry about that. So let's click in the apply and update. The next stage is the footer, I'll design it later. Now let's design the about us page. Now click in this pages, in about us page, open, edit with UX builder. It's loading now. Click in this option, template, page, full width. Now in about us page, I have to design it like that. When I need a banner and some text, so come back here, add element, search for banner, click in the simple center and apply. I have to select the background image, click in this. Let's choose this image as a background image and use this image. You can increase or decrease the height. Okay, after clicking the text box, I need this text, so just copy them and paste it here. Okay, it's done here. Now let's add some padding, because I want it some top padding and some down padding. We click in this text box and add some padding top or down. Let's add some 60 pixel and downside some 30 pixel will be fine. Okay, it's perfect. I want to change this text as no more. Okay, like that. Now I have to design this session, okay, with black background. So click here, search for session, click any one of them and click apply. After that, select the background as dark background or dark black. After that, click in the add to element, search for the text layer, text lead paragraph, apply and paste the text and make it center aligned. Okay, it's perfect. Now I have to design the stream session. So I have to take a row that will column that will contain four column. Okay, so come back and add to session, click in this, take a row that will contain four column, click in the apply. Let's give some column padding in top, something around 30 pixel. After that, click in this add element, search for team member. Okay, select the media. Let's take this image, use this image. Okay, style I'm keeping as normal only, name I'm giving some random name, title means the position you can give it here like CEO. If you want to write some text, you can do it here like I'm writing something. If you have some social media links, you can give it. I'm keeping here empty link as a hash sign. Like that, we can give it. After that, click in the apply. And after that, I have to make it more 3 times. You can duplicate it also. Drag it and keep here. Like that. Now you can just edit it here like that. Remove the picture, select media, choose this image, and after that use this image, change the name, like that. Okay, similarly I'm doing more 2 times here. I just want to tell you, you can duplicate it from here also, and after that just drag and drop like that. And after that, just edit it, remove the image, select the image. Now I'm taking this image, use image, and change the name. Okay, like that also you can do it. Click in the update. So about us page design is completed. Now I have to design the contact us page. So you can come back to the dashboard. So click on the contact us page and after that edit with UX builder. Click in this icon and in the template select the full width. Come back here. So let's check how the contact us page look like. Okay, it will look like that. So in the top section, what I need, the Google map. Okay, so add element, search for the text paragraph, normal, apply, remove that, I does not need this text. Open your Google map. Suppose this is your location, click in that. Here click in the share. There will be option called embed map. This code you need to copy. Copy it and paste it here. Now you can see this is not the full width. So for that what we do, here you can see width will be 600. Make it 100% like that. Okay, hope you understand. After that click in the apply and update. Now click in the add element, take a session, apply, and background should be dark black. Click in the element, search for row, and I need one single row and two column, mean this one two column. Click in the apply, click in the add element, search for the title. So this is will be the title. Similarly here also I need a title, and here the title will be this one. So after here I need some accordion. First of all I need this text. So here click in this, search for text, and heading text will be, so heading uppercase, or you can take this also, the lead paragraph. Click on the OK. After that I need the accordion, so click in this icon, this accordion. In accordion there will be two portion, one will be the heading. Just click here, you can see the title, so give the title whatever you want. And after that add element, the body text you have to give it as a text box paragraph. Okay, similarly for this one also. Okay, and again add element, search for text box and paragraph. Similarly I need total 5 or 6 accordion, so I'll come back after doing that. So I already create 5 accordions. Now I have to create the contact form. So for that just click in the icon, search for form, this one, and select the contact form one and apply. Now let's update it and design the footer. So I come back to the dashboard. After that click in the appearance and use it. You can see there is two footer, footer 1 and footer 2. Now come into the products and click in the footer 1. Here as you can see in the footer will be the latest product, best selling product, feature products and on sale products. So I need this product 4 times. Okay, the first one will be the latest, so give the title as latest, and order by will be date only, and make it as 4. Again add the product again. Here the title will be the best selling. Okay, and here order buying will be sales. So the top selling product will be in the top position. Okay, and make it also 4. Again, add it again, add the widget. The next one will be the feature products. So title will be the feature. Make it as 4 and make it feature products. Save it. And again, last time, add it again. Here will be the on sale products. So give the title as on sale products, make it the count as 4 and on sale products. So on sale products. Okay, save it. Now let's make the home page as default page. For that, come to the settings and general. I forgot to save them. Okay, so now settings and reading, click in this option. Home page will be home and the blog page will be blog. Post page will be blog. Okay, save the change. Now let's check the website, how it's looking now. Okay, it's coming like that. Okay, don't worry. Come back here again, the widget area, appearance and widget. I think there is some item left out. Yes, just delete them. And this also. Okay, it's perfect now. Now I have to design this one, means footer 2 area. Before that, I have to create a block. Here you can see the UX block. Click in the add new. Give the title as footer about us. Okay, now whatever the text is there, I need this text. Okay, now you can see there is some social media icon is there. So for that, what I have to do, come to the next line, take the bracket, in small letter write follow. After that, for the Facebook, equal to, you have to give your Facebook ID. I'm keeping as empty. Similarly, for the Insta, Twitter and Pinterest, and close it. After that, click in the publish. Again, come back to appearance and use it. After add this Flatsome block in the footer 2 area, so add it right here about us and select the block as this one, footer about us, which just we create. Okay, after that, clicking the save. After that, add this one, that's Flatsome recent post, add to it. Give the title as recent post and the count, make it as 4. Save it. After that, product tag cloud, add this one. And the last one, I need the text. Here write the title as address. And here you can give it your address. Okay, this is my address details. Okay, and save it. Now if you refresh the page, you can see it should come. But one thing, I want to change the color for the footer 1 and footer 2 both. Okay, so for that, what I have to do, I have to come back to the theme option, Flatsome and theme option. Click in the footer, I need this one, the dark background and white text, okay? And the background color, it is white. I need it pure black. And for the second one also, little bit dark black, like that, and publish. After that, if you refresh the page, okay, it's perfectly working. Now I want to change the text, copyright text. So here only, if you scroll it down, you can see some text is there, okay. So here you can edit, like whatever you want, you can write here. And here also there is option, but I doesn't need it. And back to top, there is two type of back to top is there. Anyone you can choose, and after that click in the publish. So now refresh the page. You can see this copyright text gets changed. Okay, now I have to design this, this header, this menu bar, this also, and the main menu bar also. Okay, here there is option, directly you can just click here. Here you can change it like Flatsome tutorial. Okay, see, let's change here, and after the publish it. After that, come back to the dashboard, come to appearance and menus, give the menu name as top menu, create menu. Let's check what we have there: about us, cart, shop, wish list, checkout. Okay, so come back here, give the position as top menu bar. Okay, and after that I need the about us, cart, shop, wish list, and checkout page. So add them. Okay, save the menu. Refresh the website. Check it here. This menu is coming. Okay, now I have to design the main menu. Mean this one, okay. So click in this, create a new menu, give the name as main menu, and click in this, create menu, click in this main menu. Okay, after that come back to here. I need the home page, about us page, shop page, contact us page, and blog page. Add them. Contact us page should be end, blog also. Okay, I need this product category, so click in this custom. Write the link text as product category, add it. Okay, this is the perfect position for it. I need the product categories, but it's not displaying. So come to the screen option, click in this product categories. Now it all will be displayed. Select all and add to menu. Now align them. Okay, it's perfect. Now save it. Refresh the website. Okay, it's coming perfect. But I want the color should be changed. Click in the header and top bar. Choose this color, okay? I think this is quite perfect. Publish. Now come back, header menu, choose this one, dark background and light text, and the background color will be exact black. Okay, keep the remaining as it is. If you want to change the text size and all, you can do it from here. I'm keeping as it is. Okay, so let's publish. Now you can see in about us page also the header is coming perfectly in black color. Okay, now I am to change the logo. Come back here, click in this logo and site identity, remove it, click in the select file, from the media library choose this size. I am recommend like width will be 400 and height will be 84 pixel. Okay, now publish it. Let's check the home page now, how it's look like now. Okay, it's perfect. Now let's log out so I can check that registration option is coming or not. So let's log out from here. Confirm the logout. As you can see, the register option is not coming, only the login option is coming. So I can log in as admin, come back to the settings, in general, check this one, anyone can register and that will be customer. Come down and save the changes. Now come back to the WooCommerce and settings. Come back to this account and privacy. You have to check all of them. Okay. And after that, click in this save change. Okay. After saving the change, let's log out. Now if you come and refresh, you can see the register form. But one thing, this is not coming like that. There you can see there is some background is there, where here it's coming as a white color. So you can log in, come back to the theme option, click in the WooCommerce, my account, here title background, select file, choose this one and select. After that publish. Let's log out here and refresh the page. Yeah, it's perfect now. Okay, hope you really like this video. If you have any question, you can ask me in the comment section. I'll give all the file in my video description link, so from there you can download and practice it. And I have a small request, please like and share this video with your friends, and please subscribe my channel, because if you subscribe, it motivates me a lot to make video like that. Thank you, have a nice day.